Bwana Yesu asifiwe. You know the drill. You know what I'll say. Vazi getini. I'm blessed to be here today, and I really thank God because of the privilege to share God's word with you. It's always an honor every single moment I am around, because it always gives me an opportunity to fellowship with my brothers and sisters and to fellowship with my spiritual father, and I bless the name of God. Can you appreciate Bishop Jimmy together with Mama Pastor Alice? I must say I'm disappointed. Can you appreciate Bishop Jimmy? You know, sometimes you don't know what you have. Sometimes you really don't get to know what you have kwa sababu ya ile kitu inaitwa familiarity. Bwana asifiwe. Kwetu Luyani tunasema ya kwamba yule mtu anaishi karibu na mtu mara mingi ndio huwa anakufa kiu. Kwa sababu they always say, I mean, we can just walk downstream and come up with water. You understand what I mean? Asante. Together with me today, I've broken the Guinness Book of Records. Together with me is my lovely wife of 10 years and my lover of 13 years. So maybe allow her to say hello. I know she doesn't like doing that, but for today...
Praise God, church. I just love the ministry. I'm happy I came. I have learned already so much that I will take back to our church. Because, you know, in our church, we have very young couples. So when I come and I get ministered with mothers and fathers, I just love it. It takes my ministry to another level. God bless you.
Thank you so much. It's always nice to see Pastor Millicent. For you, she's Pastor Millicent. To me, she's that lady who put food on my table sometime, and I'll always remember that. Hallelujah. Now, I'm told I should be up and done with by 10. And so I'll try as much as I possibly can to just condense everything that the Lord has for us today. My ministry today is very complicated because I struggled with God for 2 days on really what I should come and minister today. And while still struggling, the Lord still came out strongly and said, yeah, this is what I want you to deal with. And when I came here in the morning and what has happened so far, I was telling my wife that I am glad that finally I sit with peace, because the Lord has confirmed that indeed what he wanted me to deal with is what he is saying today. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. May we kindly open the book of Matthew chapter 25 verse 14 through to 29, but I'll not necessarily read the whole of it. I'll just pick pieces of it to pass my message home. Are we there? Matthew 25? Here, does somebody read or the speaker gets to read? Okay, chapter 25, I'll read from verse 14. For the kingdom of heaven is like a man traveling for a far country who called his own servants and delivered his goods to them. And to one he gave 5 talents, to another 2, and to another 1. To each according to his own ability, and immediately he went on a journey. I will keep reading But rather than read the whole of it and then start from verse 1 again, why don't we just go together? That's how I preach at home. For the kingdom of God is like a man traveling to a far country. That is to mean that the way God expects us, remember the Lord's Prayer? Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. So as we live our lives, there is a particular way that God would like us to live. There is a particular way that God prescribes for us to follow. Bwana asifiwe. So the kingdom of God, which is what we are supposed to be living now, the same way God intends it in heaven, is similar to what we are about to just look at. And I know it is something that is very familiar to you, but I thank God because today God will give you a different revelation altogether. Who called his own servants and delivered his goods to him? And to one he gave 5 talents, to another he gave 2, and to another he gave 1. What I want you to underscore is the fact that to each according to his own ability. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Now, the last words that Bishop said just before he invited me, he said, ukiona watu wananunua auto to 50 to a Zimmerman, na wewe unaona ya kwamba moyo wako unakutuma uende Lavington. Please do it, because that is what the Lord has prepared you for. And today I want to give you the reasons why he gave one person 1 talent, to another he gave 2, and to another he gave 5. That disparity is huge. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Are we together at the corner? I didn't get a response. Are we together around there, that county? Mtu mmoja alipewa, sema kamoja. And another one thought that this is double double. We amepewa moja. Everything a double double. You understand? He was given what? If we follow the formula, if you double 2, it's supposed to be 4. But then, hii iliongezwa zaidi. Ikakuwa ngapi? 5. Everyone according to their ability. Today, I want to question your ability. The way Bishop tried to question your manhood. Bwana sifiwe. Today, I want to question your ability. And by the time I'm through speaking, I want you to tell yourself and answer this question. Just what is your ability? If you're looking for a good topic, you have one. What is your ability? What is your ability? Your ability does not come somewhere from heaven and then it is said, now you, this is your ability. Your ability is a product of your making. Your ability is a product of your making. Your making is composed of many aspects. Your making is derived from your own relationship with God. Your making is derived from how you equip yourself. It is derived by your company. It is derived by your environment. Bwana asifiwe. When I finished college, and I was ministering as an intern at Deliverance Church, Kawasukari. Well, that's where Bishop lives, and most of you probably live there. And you know the kind of environment. Bwana sifiwe. But living in that environment made me as fresh as I was from college, made me think kama mtu wa Kawasukari. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Is somebody understanding what I'm saying? It made me think kama mtu wa Kawasukari. And my wife will give you witness that even back then, The houses I used to sketch on paper, they were not ghetto houses. Bwana asifiwe. And there are things I learned on the basis of the people I associated with. Because one day, a good friend of mine wanted to till his land back in Nanyuki. And he went and asked for somebody to give him a quotation of what it will take and cost to do that job. When he was given back the quotation, akaangalia, akasema, but if I add the 200K after being charged 10,000 per day for tractor nanini nanini, nikiongeza 200K, I will buy my own tractor and then hire a driver whom I can pay that 10,000 per month, which I would have paid per day. And then that evening he bought a tractor. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. And that was a close friend of mine. Hallelujah. Fresh from college. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. And so you can see the kind of attitudes that were planted into my spirit. So before I miss the point there, who do you keep as your company? Do you keep a company where you are the champion, even amongst the poorest? Do you keep the company where all you do is to tell stories? Akupigie ka story kajana, na wewe umpigie kajuzi? Or do you keep company of people who inspire you to go to the next level? That's why I keep coming here. Oh, let me speak like a Nigerian. That's why I keep coming, because when I come and I see the excellence of ministry around here, my mind and my spirit is challenged. And I learn something that I can take home to my own ministry. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. But if everything you do, you are the best in town. If the company you keep is a company of people who always tell you, you are good enough. By the way, I believed I was very good. Not until I met Bishop Tet. You know him, he preached here the last time I was here. Not until I met Bishop Tet. And then I realized, leave alone being good enough, I was not good. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. I'm starting from the common to the uncommon. I'm about to get to a few deeper things, and some of you might hate me by the time I'm through with the service, but you will love the message. What is your ability? If Bishop were to leave and go away for a whole 2-3 years, chances are you'll hear him giving out assignments. And he'll say, you do this, and you do this, and you do this. I want to pose a question, especially to the ministry team. I want you to remember the instructions you were given and ask yourself, why in particular were you given those instructions? Why in particular were you given those specific instructions? It's probably and most likely because it is just way close to what is considered to be your ability. Bwana asifiwe. Let me now tell you the difference between the one who was given one, the one who was given two, and the one who was given five, because they were given according to their abilities. What composes and what makes their abilities is nothing else but their attitude. Their ability has got nothing else to do with except their attitude. Somebody say attitude. Somebody say attitude. Let me read further, because there's something I'm looking for. Then he who had received the five talents went and traded with them. Unaona walianza vile walipeana moja moja, sasa matokeo inaanza juu ikirudi chini. Bwana asifiwe. The positive attitude and the right attitude of a person is known in the results that they produce. Your attitude, if you want to judge the kind of attitude you have, hey. Hapo nilihamia Kisii ama Nanyuki. If you want to know the attitude behind somebody's spirit and somebody's heart, it is found in the results. It is not in your utterances. If you want to know the worth that I am as a person, it is not in the many things that I tell you, but the results that I deliver, which comes out of my life across the spectrum of my livelihood. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Matokeo. If you want to know, and you know, the word I want to use is not a pulpit language. So I'll try to frame it so that it looks a little bit pulpit. But at the end of it all, you will know what I was running away from saying. If you want to know people who are not of so much use, Bwana Yesu asifiwe. They bring no results, but instead tell you so much about the results of other people. They don't deliver anything on the table, but they know how to tell stories. I had one such, and if you, now Bishop should not hear this. If you have that kind of a person in the ministry, you are in trouble. I had one like that. Who knows how to give the testimony of every other person? And who knows how to say the governor was actually my classmate? What about today? What about today? If you want to know people who are useful, that's a pulpit one. If you want to know people who are useful, useful people are humble about today and are inspired for tomorrow. They don't boast much about what is happening today, but they have so much to wish for, to hope for, and so much to ask you to pray with them, to stand with them, and to support them so that they can deliver something for tomorrow. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. And so the Bible begins by giving a report on the results of these people. And then he said, then he who received the 5 talents went and traded with them and made another 5 talents. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. The first attitude that you must put in your spirit is the attitude of multiplication. The attitude of multiplication, that is the attitude of Jesus Christ, because Jesus brought them in, he prepared them, he taught them, he equipped them, and he sent them out to go and multiply. In a big church like this, it is very easy. It's very easy for people to become lazy and stop multiplying, because when they look around, they see numbers and they do not see the need of working any much harder. This morning I was speaking to somebody, I was speaking to a young lady who was telling me one or two things, and I was telling that lady that, you know what, you would probably, or many people, move from one church to another imagining that they are giving themselves a chance to grow. So you move from Progressive Church where I preach and then move to Deliverance Church, which is bigger. Why? Because you say, I feel I want to grow. Sometimes it is not growth that you are experiencing. Maybe you are just experiencing something different from what you're experiencing before. While in real sense, when you stop growing, ask yourself, why are you not growing? You are not growing because you have made yourself a recipient of the gospel. You have made yourself a recipient of God's goodness. You have made yourself a recipient of God's grace, but you have never availed yourself as a giver of the same. The day you will start giving the grace of God, the day you will start giving the goodness of God and being an instrument that can be used to dispense the power of God, to show the glory of God, then you will grow. But for as long as you continue being a baby in the morning, baby in the night, baby year out, then you will say you are not growing, not because the church is not taking you to the next level, but simply because you have refused to grow up from a boy into a man. The kingdom of God is in the business of multiplication. The kingdom of God is in the business of growth. The kingdom of God is in the business of expansion. The question is, as a man, and sometimes men don't like me, when God entrusts you with the leadership of your family and you stay with that lady year in, year out, 5, 4, 6, 20. What have you multiplied in that family? What growth have you brought to that family? Now, let me not use the word growth. Let me use the word you love to relate with easily. Maendeleo. Umeleta maendeleo gani? In that which God has entrusted you with. Most of us are not keen on growth. Most of us are not keen on increase. Most of us are not keen on making what we found better than we found it. And you'll regret some quotes that are clearly in the Bible. But he who had, okay, verse 16. Then he who had received 5 talents went and traded with them and made another 5 talents. He doubled. And likewise, he who had received 2 gained 2 more also. Verse 18. But he who had received 1 went and dug in the ground and hid his Lord's money. Alifanya nini? Alifanya nini? I want you to give me the right word. What did he do? What did he do? I want to hear. What did he do? The right term is alificha. Bwana sifiwe. The Bible says that to whom more is given, much more is expected. God gives us many talents every other time. There are people who ask me, why do you do this and also do this and also do this? I say, it is because God gave me all those. And everything I do, I consider it a calling. And I respond to it because it is a calling. And I respond to it because God has given me and I don't want to hide any of it. But then some of us, God has given us and entrusted us with so many talents. Lakini, kuna wengine yetu, tuliamua kuficha. And do you know why alificha? You should hear this. It's so sad. Verse 20. So he who received 5 talents came and brought 5 other talents, saying, Lord, you delivered to me 5 talents. Look, I have gained 5 more talents besides them. Come on, people who have the attitude of multiplication have no problem giving reports. People who have the attitude of multiplication do not even source for the report to give. It comes on their fingertips. When you ask them, when you are far away and ask, how is this and how is that? They tell you, as for this one, this is what we did. As for this one, this is how far we have come. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. One day I met Bishop Kimani at Deliverance Church, Kawaskari. I think he was preaching there on a Sunday. And then when I went to greet him, and he asked me, actually the first question he asked me, habari ya mke wako? With his eyes wide open and looking at me straight into the eye to see whether I will blink. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Of course I did not fumble because I did not have a problem that end. Hallelujah. It has been 10 good years of God's goodness. Hallelujah. We've never sat down with our best couple for anything, never called in our parents even once, and we've never packed or even thought about it. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. We only think about increasing and increasing and increasing. Hallelujah. Because when you have the attitude of multiplication, you always make sure you have a good report to give. You always make sure that you want to know how many chicken have hatched. Na mayai ngapi iliharibika. So anytime you ask, very quickly you will say, unfortunately, two did not make it. But I have six good reports. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Our attitude must be that of multiplication, and we must be able to give account of what we are doing with ourselves. Make sure your report is intact. Do not take a trip to Mombasa for 3 weeks using taxpayers' money simply because you want to write a report. You know what I'm talking. I mean, that's the, I almost said a word that is not pulpit. That is the circus that our leaders subject us to tell us that, you know what, we need a report. And then this report, we also need to spend money to facilitate a committee which investigates the report. Let me drop that one. Is your report always with you? Bwana asifiwe. Do you always have a report? His Lord said to him, well done, good and faithful servant. You are faithful over a few things. I will make you ruler over many. Enter into the joy of your Lord. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Having a good report means being a good steward. Providing a good report means you are being a good steward. When you are a good steward, stewardship comes with reward automatically. You don't ask for it, it just finds you. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. When you are a good steward, the reward just falls into place. The Lord and the Master said, well done, good and faithful servant. How many times, if the Lord came today, will he tell you, good and faithful servant? If the Lord were to come to your house, will he tell you, good and faithful servant, you've taken good care of your children who are my children? Can the Lord walk into your place of work and say, thou good and diligent servant? Can the Lord walk into your office? Now, forget about your boss. Of course, you know most of the time he does not say good and faithful. But forget about your boss, your employer. Let's talk about Jesus. If Jesus were to walk into your office, will he tell you, good and faithful servant? Will he? If God is to find you in the vineyard working, would he tell you, good and faithful servant? Bwana sifiwe. He also, who had received 2 talents, came in and said, Lord, you delivered to me 2 talents. Look, I have gained 2 more talents besides them. His Lord said, well done, good and faithful servant. You have been faithful over a few things. I will make you ruler over many things. Enter into the joy of your Lord. Let me finish with this. Then he who had received the 1 talent came and said, Lord, I knew you to be a hard man, reaping where you have not sown and gathering where you have not scattered seed. Excuses. Excuses. People who do not have the attitude of multiplication and stewardship always have an excuse. They always have, you know, an excuse is a fake explanation. Bwana sifiwe. They always have an explanation to give and say that, you know, and you know this even in your houses, and you are there sometime, that, you know, I am number 48 because these are streams put together. 3 streams. These are 3 streams put. So what about your stream hiyo moja ulikuwa namba ngapi? Are we together? We always have an excuse. And we borrowed this from our ancestor. We borrowed this from our father. And good sons correct the mistakes of their fathers. Good sons correct the mistakes of their fathers. You don't have to do the same mistakes that your father did and then tell yourself, after all, that's what my father did. Our father made the first mistake, and when God asked him for a report, he said, the woman you gave me, The woman you gave me. The woman that you gave me. Nowadays, munapewangwa. Munapewangwa. Eh? I need answers. Munapewangwa. You find, isn't it? You find, and after you have found, it is your responsibility. Kazi ni kwa? Neema inatoka kwa Mungu, lakini kazi ni kwako. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Adam said, the woman that you gave me. Adam gave an excuse of the stewardship of God. So my question is, when Adam was not a good steward, we know the end result. So, do you want to follow the same excuse and follow the same results? Because only a fool, at least the Bible says so. A fool says in his heart that there is no God. Now, that's not what I want to say. I'm using the word fool. So, Bishop, pardon me. I'm using the word fool. A fool is that man or woman who does the same thing over and over again and expects a different result. So if you are trying to do things the same way that Adam did, if you're making excuses the same way Adam did, if you're following the same route and finding somebody to blame and finding somebody to hold responsible so that you can escape responsibility, then what are you being? What are you being? Because you are doing the same thing and expecting a different result. Excuses. Excuses. We must quit and walk away from excuses. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. The man who was given one talent was lazy. For a fact. Ukweli ama uongo. And that helps me define how our society looks like. And you probably belong to one of them. I'm done with 2/3 of my sermon. I have 1/3 to go. So you better follow me very closely. Our society has 4 groups of people. 3 have been said in the Bible. 1 had an ability for 1 talent. But there is a group of people who have no ability at all. And I'm not talking about disability. There is a group of people who have no ability at all. They wake up in the morning and they say, Sirikali nisaidie, Sirikali nisaidie, naomba Sirikali ingilie kati. That is a group of people whom I always refer to in my cluster of categories, hopeless people. Hopeless people are people who have given up in life. By the way, when you give up in life, you die. Even when we see you walking, even you know. Your story yako ilisha kitambo. There is a category of people in the house of God. Our serikali saidi. They always say they don't have money. And I'm getting to now much deeper things. They always say they don't have money, they don't have anything to do, they don't have anything to give. Hata ukiitisha sadaka kanisani, ama wakati tunajenga wao nasema, wacha Reverend Mwithi afanye hiyo, hao ndio wakona, hao ndio wakona pesa. Hao ndio Mungu alikumbuka, hao ndio walibariki. Those fellows don't give, those fellows don't tithe. Those fellows don't do anything in church. They don't even realize that their time is money. They don't realize that one day Jesus was looking at the offering basket and one poor widow, not one poor woman, one poor and also widow gave her last coin and it was credited as righteousness unto her. They forget that when God wanted to feed Elijah after the ravens were through with duty and he wanted to change the menu a little bit, God sent Elijah to a widow's house. Bwana sifiwe. And when God sent Elijah to that widow's house, God knew very well that that widow, even in her poverty, had the ability to give. Because she told the prophet, "Servant of God, I don't have anything." But at least she had the ability to reveal the little that was remaining. She had the ability to say, "Except a bowl of flour and a little oil to make our last meal before I and my son dies." So if you belong to that category of, I don't like using that word, but if you call yourself poor, if you choose to call yourself poor, you have no excuse whatsoever not to do God's work. You have no excuse whatsoever not to put your money in the house of God. You have no excuse, because poor people have been proven to be true even in poverty. Poor widows have been proven in the Bible to give. So when you are building your cathedral and you say that is a preserve of the millionaires, you lie and you make God a liar. Mimi sina kitu. Kwa kiluya watu nasema, pule shinduta. Sina kitu hata. Because this is not my pulpit, I'm being very careful with my words. When it's my pulpit and I know you are my responsibility, and when you get it wrong, you are my burden, I hit it right on the head without mincing my words. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. There is another category of people, they call themselves hustlers. Hustlers have no problem receiving. But to give.
Hiyo ni kukamua ng'ombe ya kukamua ng'ombe ya Masai. Unajua ng'ombe za Masai zinanga maziwa, zinakuanga na nyama tu.
If you didn't know, that's a fact. I stayed in Masai land and I've worked there for many years. Ng'ombe ya Masai atakamua saa 11 asubuhi, atoke hapo na kikombe hii moja. I mean, it's a fact. Huko hakuna maji. Hata malisho ni shida. Hustlers belong to this category of one talent. And I want you to choose where you belong, or at least where you want to belong. Hustlers are very good when a man of God says, "Bring your money at the feet of the apostle and you will be blessed." They will be the first ones to run. They will be the first ones to run. Hustlers do not give out of love. Hustlers give for something in return. They say, "What is in it for me?" The attitude of a hustler is the exact attitude which says, "I know that you are a shrewd master. I know who pastor tunamujua. Tunamujua. Unaona hata hiyo pesa ni pesa yetu." That is the language of the, and you know I'm not lying. And you know I'm saying the truth. Hustlers, God knows your ability. God knows your ability. God knows you cannot handle even 100K. God knows even 50K is too much. It is sufficient for you to get a kashungwa. 50. God knows very well. Akikuinua, wacha hapa hata. Akikutoa tu hapa, kusongeshe karibu na ista ya kwanza. Kidogo tu, hata chacha hatuta kuona. Maombi hatuta kuona. Fellowship hatuta kuona. Na kama ulisalimianga bishop hivi, unarudi unamsalimia na mkono kwa mfuko. Wale ambao mko na watoto, tafadhali, someshenu watoto wenu. Bwana asifiwe.
Muombe walimu warudi shule, watoto wafundishwe. Bishop umeshai kutana na mchungaji wa class 8. Usikie testimony yake. Usikie testimony yake. Vile, and the people with the degrees were there listening to me. And all the rich were listening and saying, yes, servant of God. Hii shida ya kukosa elimu ndio inafanyanga Mungu anakubariki na kakitu kadogo tu ka Range Rover. Ah boss, dunia lazima ijue. Lazima wajue niko. Lazima wajue mimi ndio mwanaume. Same thing to hustlers. Mungu akikubariki kidogo, sadaka yako ikipanda tu kutoka 200 ndio unatoanga 500, haki unatoa watu wakiona. Yet people write checks za 1 million wamenyamaza. People have more than 6 degrees na wamenyamaza. Wewe hata certificate ya form 4 ujaenda kuchukua, unataka tujue ulifika. Hustlers are always given one talent until you learn the attitude of contentment. Until God brings you to the place of the attitude of contentment. The attitude of contentment. Okay, so what is the solution? Tazema, you just castigated us na ukatuacha kwa mata. What is the solution? Number one, repent. Bwana sifiwe. Repent, ambia Mungu, my attitude was wrong. Forgive me. Heal my attitude. Heal my spirit. And let me learn from you. Bwana sifiwe. Do you know the other thing you need to do? It is a difficult thing to do. Because now, you will not walk yourself. How can you walk yourself where you don't know? You will need to have a friend or two. Ambao wako mbele yako kidogo. Tembea na wao. Tembea nao. And admit. Admit that you want to be trained. Admit that you want to be taught. In our church one day, I prayed for a certain gentleman. You know, by the grace of God, sometimes God ministers in word of knowledge. So I told him, okay, this is what is in your future. But then I see this roadblock, but you know, I prayed over the situation and I told him. So one day he went to office and he was promoted 2 ranks above his rank. And of course his salary came 3 times what he was earning. And he was very excited. Oh, he was very quick to promise even what he will do in church. He was very quick, and this is real, Bishop. I'm not speaking figuratively, I'm speaking very specific. He even said the keyboard ya kanisa, hallelujah. Na mmoja anasema kwa madhabahu na hakuna mtu alimuuliza. My wife can bear witness that your keyboard na wa leo bado. Akini Mungu alimrudisha tu arudi aende afanye class. Nikasema maybe hii vipawa vingine Mungu atusaidie, because saa nyingine kuna vipawa Mungu huwa anatupatia, tunaona hatua 7 mbele yako, yet you are supposed to go through all the stages 1 2 3 4. So tukiona hatua 7 tunakusaidia kufika in the 7th grade. But because you've not been trained for the 3rd, the 4th and the 5th and the 6th, inaku. So recently in church, there are 2 guys who didn't like me so much because I told them on their face that I actually know really, really what the Lord has for you, but I don't think you're mature enough to handle that, so we'll start here. And if we walk together, then I'll release you into what I see. Because I saw myself destroy one. Bwana asifiwe. Accept to be mentored. Accept to be taught. Accept to be trained. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. The place of contentment is the place of 2 talents.
So from hustlers, you get to a group of people whom we call the Assured Club. The Assured Club. Assurance, eh? The Assured Club. These are fellows who, if you say, tunajenga cathedral, and we need some money, hata kama hana, at least anajua, huyu Mungu anatembeanga na yeye, anaweza provide you 100K. So they can commit that 100K without knowing where it will come from, but at least they know it will come. They walk by faith, and they are fairly content, and that is where much of our society is. There is another category where most of us never get there, because that place has a problem, and it has a problem of a combination of the hopeless and the hustler group. The place of contentment is the place of two talents. It is the place of faithfulness. It is the place where David says, God, do not give me poverty, but also don't give me riches. You know, David knew his limitations. We look at him and we see riches, but David knew how to deal with his weaknesses. He knew his weaknesses. The place of contentment is the place of people who are faithful in church. They will tithe. They will give. At least when they give to the church or to the servants of God, they will not talk about it. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Lakini nguruwe yao moja ikikufa wanaomboleza. Matatu yao moja ikipata ajali, anapata ulcers, hypertension, anaenda hospitali. Gari moja ikibreak down, nobody will know peace at home. Hata mama atatukanwa. What is it, city? Sama, just leave me alone. Just leave, tutaongea kesho. So we are content, but at the same time, we hold too much on what we have. We are content, but what we have, we call ours. We are content, but what we have is so valuable that when we part with it, it's like a whole world taken away from us. You remember Ananias and Sapphira? At the time when the church was selling everything they have and bringing for it to be shared among everybody, they purposed in their heart, in the book of Acts. They purposed in their spirit, wakaenda wakauza, vile unaongeaga na mama, unasema ya kwamba, hii pesa tukipata, hii pension, eh? Tukipata hii pension, sio 10%, tutatoa 20%. Unakuja unaambia bishop, you know there was this problem, there was this. We are trusting God, to remember us. But after God remembers you, yes, you give, but you change, you adjust your heart a little bit. You remember there is school fees, okay? So the pledge that you had made, you say, wacha nipeane hii kwanza. Wacha nipeane hii kwanza. Hii ingine, I know God will provide. I know God will. Kama aliprovide Abraham, hata mimi atafanya nini? And that is why, Bishop, and I'm closing in the next 5 minutes. That is why, have you ever gone to a Muslim's shop at one? Have you? What does it do? And it does not matter how much money you're putting on the table. It does not matter. Lakini wewe acha kabiashara, kadil. Wacha kadil katokeleze. Acha kadil katokeleze. Ata, hey.
church itajipanga. Even if you are the one who was scheduled to lead worship, Pastor Millicent, Pasi, kunangori mahali, kunangori mahali, iyo mi naweza nika lead next Sunday. Please just ask. Ama mi mwenyewe ni bonge na nani? Bwana Yesu asifiwe. If a Muslim was traveling, it does not matter whether he's on a jet, at least a faithful one, yeah? It does not matter whether he was traveling on a jet, whether he was driving a trailer, whether he was riding his car, wakati wa maombi zao hiyo tano ikifika, he parks on the side of the road, kneels down, and prays to his God. How much we mock our God. How much we mock our God. That is why you will continue being just good enough. Wenye wanakuangalia wanaona uko sawa. Kwanza wanaona wewe ni tajiri because you probably have two cars in the family. At least unaishi kwako. Wanakuona uko sawa. But you know very well you're struggling with the loans. You know very well hata kwa shule kuna deni. You know very well hata mmegombana na mama jana kwa sababu hii hesabu haikuingiana. Ulivuta sana upande wako. It is because your attitude has refused to let go completely. There is a place that you will reach and you will be able to do much more than even what Muslims do. Because, I don't know, my mom comes from a Muslim family, so I relate with them and I know quite a bit about them. And I have never had a single day kukiwa na harambe ya kujenga msikiti. Never. Never. Mosques are built by an individual who books himself a ticket to his so-called heaven. What about my rich Christians? And I'm saying rich with sarcastic because those who think are rich are actually just operating on two talents. And when the Bible says that the little which was ile ya ule mtu mmoja, ile talanta moja, ilichukuliwa ikapewa wa huyu ta, when it is taken from the lazy and the hustle group, it will not be given to you. It will be given to the one who was faithful with five. The day God blessed you, Bishop Joker, I had him listening, saying one day that there's a man who came to him and said, "Oh, Apostle, pray for me. You know, when I was jobless and when I was earning 10,000 shillings, I was faithful, I was tithing, I was doing God's work, I was doing. But nowadays, I don't. I have a problem." "How much do you earn?" "No, I'm now a millionaire." But so I'm kneeled down. Those of you who have interacted with Dr. Kayo know what I'm talking about. And he said, "Lord, demote this man." "Demote this man to 10,000. The guy removed the hand and said, "No." Then he told him, "Then go and do the right thing. Go and do the right thing." When from job, his wealth was taken in a single day. When his children were taken away in a single day, his camels and his goats and his sheep and his cattle were taken away in a single day, and he was given that report on a single day. Job never went into depression. Job never had ulcers. He never had hypertension. He said, "Naked from my mother's womb I came, and naked I shall go. The Lord gives and the Lord takes." It is only when your heart and your attitude will get to that point, only then will one man rise up and build the temple of God. Only then will one man rise up and write a check of 6 million and not think about it. Because there is a place we have never been able to go. There is a place we've never allowed ourselves to go. Because James chapter 4, 13 to 17 says, "Do not boast about tomorrow.
but lay it all in God's hand and will. We say that tomorrow we'll travel in a far country and buy this and buy that, instead of saying, if God wills, I will. David went out for many battles, and there is no single day that he said, tomorrow morning they will know me. No, he said, always, and read it very well, always, David always prayed and said, God, if you will grant me, and if it shall be your will, then tomorrow morning none of them shall be alive. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. As I make my last statement, it is possible for you to be rich. It is very possible for you to be rich, especially if your heart can get to that point where you can part with what you have without necessarily doing it so that God does it in return. It is possible for you to be wealthy. There are so many scriptures that talk about, and maybe, we will not read, just write them and go read. They will help you back at home. James chapter 4, 13 to 17. When you finish, you say I, so that I give you the next one. James 5, 1 to 6. 1 Timothy 6, 17 to 19. Ecclesiastes 9, 14 to 16. And maybe somebody should open for me. I read that and then I will pray. Ecclesiastes 9, 14 to 16. Ecclesiastes iko wapi? Oh, nimeipata. Oh, mko digital. There was a little city with few men in it, and a great king came against it, besieged it, and built great snares around it. Let's proceed. Now, there was found in it a poor wise man, and he by his wisdom delivered the city. Yet no one remembered that same poor man. It is sad that we do not operate like John the Baptist, because John the Baptist was wealthy in his own way, and people looked for him all the way down in the wilderness. And there is one man known as Elisha. You know the story of Naaman, who was leprous? When report came to Naaman that he be cured, he went out to look for Elisha, and when he got to the house of Elisha hakukuwa na pressure ya kumuona. Do you know what Elisha did? Elisha sent a messenger. Akaambia, enda umwambie aende Jordan ajimwogele mara saba. And even when this Naaman was stubborn and later submitted, realized he still had leprosy, na akaenda akaogelea akapona, he brought back some money, and Elisha refused to take that money. Why? I would believe Elisha was rich in his own class. Elisha was rich in his own class. Bwana asifiwe. The church today is suffering because the people of God have refused to grow, to be man enough to be able to have the heart and attitude to handle riches. And so because the church does not have resources, we are tossed left, right, and center with the wind. Umeshai realize ya kwamba ile makanisa ya ghetto. Mnisamehe kusema hata bishop tanisamehe. Umeshai realize kwamba ile makanisa ya ghetto yenye ukienda tu ukiangalia. Umejua kuna mtu utaangalia tu, kuna mtu utaangalia tu. Ka madam nikikuangalia tu, I can tell you how much your dress costs.
you understand what I'm saying? Lakini sana sana kienda ghetto utaenda hata ukipiga mtu hesabu kutoka juu mpaka chini haifiki ngiri. But have you realized that when those televangelists sell oil and ask for money ya TV na hii ingine, do you realize 500k zinatokanga? Do you realize zinatokanga? But do these people, if you go 5 years, you will find that person in the same class, still at the same class of their lives. Why? Because they always trade in. They don't give. They trade in. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Mungu atusaidie. Mungu atusaidie. Let's rise up and make a closing prayer. I'm sorry, I've spent much more than I should have. I want you to ask God to just speak to your heart and speak to your spirit that from today, your attitude will change. Go ahead and say that yourself. Ask God to give you a contrite spirit and the right attitude towards being a steward of God's resources in your life. Just go ahead and speak to the Lord according to how you've understood today's word. Father, I pray this morning that somebody's life will be transformed today. That our hearts and our attitudes will be right before you. We shall be good stewards of your resources. We will have the right spirit, knowing that you are the giver of every resource. And we are just stewards. Everything we have under our names, none of it belongs to us, but it belongs to you. Father, you will help us to multiply that which you have given us. You will walk with us that we shall multiply that which is in our hands. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, we love you today and we honor you. Bishop, I'm struggling with this, what to do or what not to do. Do you mind if I beg you to just come? I inquire from you. Everybody, just raise your hands towards heaven and let's pray. Father, thank you for your people. Thank you for everybody who has purposed in their hearts to be delivered of financial impropriety. I pray that, Lord, everyone that has exhibited impropriety in their finances, heal us today. Heal us today. Heal us today. Heal us today. Deliver us today. Deliver us today. Deliver us today. I declare a healing and a deliverance in your life. I declare a healing and deliverance over your finances. You shall not struggle in your finances anymore. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, may the cleansing power of God cleanse our hearts, cleanse our spirits, cleanse our minds, cleanse our attitudes, cleanse our spirits, cleanse our hearts, Jehovah God, and give us a new beginning today.
Give us a new beginning today. Give us a new beginning today. Give us a new beginning today. Thank you, King of all glory, for healing our finances. Because from today, my Father, we are going to be pure before you. We are going to be pure as we deal with you. We are going to be pure in our hearts, pure in our conscience, pure in our deeds, pure in every way that we deal with you, with the resources that you have entrusted with us. We are starting all over again. And let the grace of God be released upon each faithful one. Let the grace of God be released upon each faithful one according to the principles of the Word of God. Let a new grace of expansion flow. Let a new grace of increase manifest. Let a new grace of provision prevail. Let a new grace of prosperity prevail. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name. 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 May you all receive the miracle of God. And I know that as I prayed, it's already happened. We were praying with my wife at 4 a.m. in the morning. And God showed me various things and various miracles that he wants to do in this place. And I declare that let all those miracles be established. Let all of them be established. Let all of them come to pass. Just receive the touch of God wherever you are. Receive the touch of God and receive the ministry of Jehovah upon your life. May the Lord heal your life and heal your body. May the Lord restore your spirit. May the Lord restore your ministry. May the Lord restore your family. May the Lord heal your finances. May he heal every sickness. Every ulcer, I command healed in Jesus' name. I command that sick scalp on the head to be healed right now in the name of Jesus Christ. I command every sickness, even that who is sick in your genitals, I command that you are healed right now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Be healed and be delivered and be set free in Jesus' name. I command every fibroid to be healed. I command every fibroid to be healed. I command every fibroid to be healed in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. You've lost your marriage. I command restoration upon your marriage in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I command restoration to your business in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. May the miracles of the Lord and the power of the Holy Spirit manifest upon your life. May the glory and the Spirit of the Lord manifest upon your life. Let's all give glory and thanks to Jehovah. Amen.